greater than guilt, louder than shame. This reckless love will never be tamed. Your passionate heart can never be bound. Demons will flee and heaven will sound. That nothing is as strong as your love.
Hey there! Is today your first time here? Or maybe your first time in a while? If so, maybe you're wondering exactly who we are and what this church is all about. Well, we'd like you to know that we're a group of ordinary people who are on an amazing journey together, following Christ. Our guide is the Bible because it's the divinely inspired Word of God and it will never take us in the wrong direction. Along the way, we hope you'll see that we are welcoming and spiritually passionate and that getting to know you is a big deal to us. We know that the road is rough sometimes, but we'll work really hard to bring you practical and relevant messages to equip and encourage you through life's ups and downs. We want you to know that we care about this community, and we believe that it's our job to make it a better place. So, no matter who you are or where you've been, we're glad you're here with us today. And we hope that you'll join us on our journey, following Christ and living out His plan for us. So, welcome to church.
Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one.
Hey family, we're so glad you could join us for this time together tonight. We've been missing you, we've been missing all the gatherings. Seeing each other from a distance is just not the same. It's not cool, but it's been good to connect with you via WhatsApp, via Facebook, via Google Hangout Meet, because I believe connection is so important. Please know that we have been praying for you, we've been thinking about you, and right now, just allow me to share an A-hug with you. I hope you feel better now. This morning, I've just been thinking about the goodness of God, and just allow me to share two scriptures with you. The first one is found in Psalms 27 verse 30 in the Passion Translation, and it reads as follows. Yet I totally trust you to rescue me one more time so that I can see once again how good you are while I'm still alive. The other one is found in Nahum 1 and it reads as follows. The Lord is good, a strength and stronghold in the day of trouble. He recognizes, cares for, and fully understands those who take refuge in Him. Family, I believe that the Lord has been so good to all of us. He's kept us alive, He's kept us healthy, He's kept us strong. And I believe that we will continue to experience and to see the goodness of the Lord while we are still alive. So I encourage you to take refuge in Him, because He alone is your source, He's your strength, and He's your stronghold. Let's just pray. Father, I thank you for this time that we have together. I thank you, Lord, that even in this trying time, you are still continuing to bless us and to be our strength and our stronghold, Lord. Lord, this evening we take refuge in you because you are our source of everything. Thank you, Father. We worship and we praise you. Amen. So before we go over to the Word of God, preached by Pastor Clayton Rose tonight, just enjoy this time of worship, and we'll see you again soon.
night has fallen, when fear is coming, still you're calling me. When faith is lost and my hope exhausted, you will be my strength. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. Yeah, I've decided I'm not giving up, 'cause you won't give up on me. You won't give up on me. Your love is holding on and it won't let go. I feel it breaking out like an echo. Says to me, whoa, now there's no stopping what you have started until it is complete. When my mind says I'm not good enough, God, you're enough for me. Yeah, I decided I'm not giving up, 'cause you won't give up on me.
So happy that you joined us this week again for Hill City Online. We are so grateful that you take some time out just to hear the word of God. We trust you were encouraged by that song that was just played and by the message that Pastor Cindy brought just before we went into the song. If you're joining us and you're not part of our Hill City family, won't you drop us a comment just to let us know if you're watching and if you are blessed by this message. I have a short encouragement today that I want to share with you that I feel God just laid upon my heart. It's not going to be a long message, but I hope it will be encouraging enough to just get you through another day. It's found in 2 Kings chapter 6 verse 24 and in chapter 7 verse 1. Verse 24 says that when the king of Syria, Ben-Hadad, I'm paraphrasing now, gathered all the armies and besieged Samaria, and there was a famine in the land. Verse 1 of chapter 7 says that the prophet was in the palace and he said, tomorrow about this time there will be bread in Samaria. He's speaking in a famine, but he's prophesying that there will be bread in Samaria. And verse 2 says that the servant on whom the king's hand leaned said, even if God opens up the windows of heaven, it cannot be done. And today I just want to encourage you very shortly that God is in control. God is in control. You see, sometimes in our lives, We have choices that we can make. We can choose what type of wife we marry. We can choose what type of partner we live with, or what type of person we want to be in relationship with. We can choose what clothes we wear, or how our hairstyle must be. We have chosen type of shoes and type of house we live in. We have all types of choices, but there comes a time in our lives where we find ourselves in situations where there is no control over the type of situations we are in. We have no say in the type of financial situation we're in. We have no say in type of problems we find ourselves in. It just catches unaware and blindsides us, and it feels like we have no control. But when we have no control, God is still in control. You see, the Sumerians, they did not ask to be in a famine. The Bible actually says that a king came and gathered armies and surrounded them and besieged them. Took everything they have, their crops, their gold, their money, their food, everything. That it was so bad that two mothers would come and say, today we'll eat my son, tomorrow we'll eat yours. It was so bad that they started eating the droppings of birds just to stay alive. But in the midst of such a difficult time, the word of the Lord came out and said, tomorrow about this time, there will be bread in Samaria. You see, sometimes in a hard time, and when you go through difficult situations with this, where you have no control over, all you have to do is get hold of the word of God. The word of God brings hope and light. The word of God builds you up. The word of God brings faith into you. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God. You see, when you have in a situation like we are now today, in a pandemic, we were told to stay at home for 5 weeks. Some people listening to this message today has no income. They're praying to God just for their next meal. But I wanted to let you know, when you are not in control, God is still in control. And in the midst of the situation, the word of the Lord is coming to you today to say, tomorrow about this time. I don't know how God can do it. We can never understand His ways. We can never understand what He does and how He does it. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah that His ways are higher than ours, and His thoughts are higher than ours. We cannot outthink God. We cannot logically understand the way God does. All we have to do is have faith in Him and know that He is still in control. In the midst of a difficult situation, the word of God says tomorrow about this time. And for you today, you may be sitting in a situation where money is a bit tight, or things are a bit hard and difficult. Things in your home might not be okay. But I want to let you know that God is still in control. If you can just give it over to Him, He'll take it. You see, when we are not in control, He's still in control. Sometimes we as humans, we want to be in control of everything, every move, everything that happens in our lives. But sometimes God places us in the middle of a situation to let you know that when it's beyond your control, it is not beyond His control. He is still God. I love the song that says, you are God alone since time began. You are on your throne. You see, there is no situation that can dethrone Him. He is ruler, He is sovereign, He's over everything. There is nothing that God does not know about. There's nothing that God cannot do. There's nothing that's impossible for Him, the Bible says. For with God, nothing is impossible. Your situation today might seem like it's an impossible one. You don't know where the money is going to come from. You don't know where the food is going to come from. You don't know how things are going to change for you. But I want to encourage you today that God is still in control. You might be feeling depressed. You might be feeling like giving up and saying, I had enough. I don't know how we're going to do it. I don't know which way to turn. I want you to know today, turn to Him. The Bible says, looking unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. Sometimes we want to look in all types of places, but I like the way David says in the Psalms, not anyone, I lift up my eyes to the hills from whence my help comes. Your help is from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Today I want you to know that God is in control of your life. He's in control of your situation. If you can just trust Him, He'll come through for you. These people in Samaria, they did not know that the word of God was being released, but they ate the fruit of the word. That the Bible says that four leprous men were placed outside the gate and they were busy dying. But one of them said, why do we sit here and die? They did not hear the word, but they were reacting on something that was stirring inside of them. Your faith can move even the most impossible situation to become possible. Today I want you to know that you're one step away, one prayer away, one act of faith, one gift, one giving away from your blessing and from your breakthrough. And so today I want to encourage you, God is still in control. I want to close off very quickly with this portion of scripture that I found, and it really blessed me this week as I was reading. It's found in Joel chapter 2, verse 25 and 26. And maybe we'll read 27 as well. And I want to speak this word over you and over your home and over your family today. Joel chapter 2, verse 25. This is what the Lord says. So I will restore to you the years that the swarming locusts have eaten, crawling locust, the consuming locust, and the chewing locust, my great army which I have sent among you. You and your family shall eat in the plenty and be satisfied, and praise the name of the Lord your God, who has dealt wondrously with you. And my people, which is you, shall never be put to shame. Then you shall know that I am in the midst of Israel. I am the Lord your God, and there is no other. My people shall never be put to shame. I want to let you know today that God can do it for you. If no man can, God can. If no one can, God can do it for you. Do not know where to turn to, turn to God. If you do not know where to go, go to God. He says here in his word, and I want to prophesy, I will restore to you. I know some of you are feeling the lack, some of you are feeling the pinch right now, but God said, I will restore to you the years or the weeks or the days or the months that this virus has consumed. And you, I like what verse 26 says, you shall eat in plenty and be satisfied. I pray this will be your portion now, today and forevermore. God is still in control. You don't have to worry about a thing. He's taking care of you up until now, and he will not stop. And so as I close off today, I want to just release a prayer over you very quickly and release the Lord's blessing over you, and we hope to see you next week again. Let's pray together. Father, I thank you that we could sit around your word. Thank you that you remind us today that you are still in control. I pray for every person watching this broadcast today, whatever their situation may be, I pray that you touch them today, lift them, build them up by your word. I pray that you come through for those who are trusting you for a miracle. I pray for divine provision to be their portion. I pray for those who are watching this broadcast, dear God, that even divine protection will be their portion, that the blood of Jesus covers their home, their families, that no sickness and disease will come near them or touch them. We pray, dear God, that the blessing of God will rest upon their home, that from the north and the south, you will send your angels to be a blessing to them. We thank you, dear God, that you are in control. Even when it seems like we are not in control, you remain in control today. And we thank you, dear God, that your word says tomorrow about this time. I pray for a tomorrow about this time blessing for somebody watching. In Jesus' mighty name, let your will be done and let your kingdom come, I pray. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, thank you again so much for watching this week with us. We trust you were encouraged by this short message. God bless you and your family. May the Lord bless you and keep you, give you his peace now and forevermore. In Jesus' name, we love you and we'll see you soon.